With October being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, it provides an excellent opportunity for women everywhere to make sure they are up to date on the latest health information and getting the proper screenings each year. Here to help educate us on breast health, we have Baptist Medical Group experienced OBGYN, Dr. Leslie Sanders. Welcome, Dr. Sanders. We're so happy to have you.
Thanks for having me. Happy to be here.
Absolutely. Well, to get us started, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and what led you to become an OBGYN?
Sure. Well, I've always enjoyed women's health and women's health issues. I feel like as a woman, I'm able to connect with patients on a more intimate level. And I also think that it's very special to be able to be a part of some of the most intimate and important parts of their lives.
Well, can you tell us a little bit about breast cancer and how this disease is detected?
Sure. Well, breast cancer is cancer of the breast tissue. Cancer is when you have cells that are abnormally growing. There are lots of different types of breast cancer. The most common is ductal carcinoma, and that's when breast cancer starts in the milk ducts of the breast tissue.
Okay, so what can women do to help prevent breast cancer from happening as far as screenings, any tests they can do to kind of see it early on in the process?
Sure, so early detection is going to be key. There are lots of different ways that we monitor it. One way would be to visit your doctor or your clinician's office and find out what your risk is for breast cancer, as there are several factors, exposures, environmental, your family history, and your exposure to estrogen that can influence that risk. Mm-hmm. Once you determine what your risk is, we can better determine what sort of screenings you should have. We recommend that a woman that's over the age of 20 have a clinical breast exam, and that's when your clinician examines your breasts, and they'll also teach you how to examine your breasts so that you can know what to look for when examining your breasts or looking at them, mm-hmm. how they feel. In addition, we also have mammography for breast cancer screening, and that's recommended for a woman every year after the age of 40. Sometimes it can be earlier depending on what your risk is.
So when you're doing self-exams, I know sometimes we can freak out because it can be kind of weird and not really sure
right.
what we're looking for. So what would you recommend so that someone's not, when they're actually doing a self-exam, to know what they're looking for and not panicking because, again, it can feel kind of weird?
Sure. So your breasts can change, and they do change depending on where you are in your life, whether you're lactating, you're a new mother, whether you're young or older. So really examining your breasts we recommend every month after your period. So you're doing it at the same time every month and getting to know what they look and feel like. Breasts may be lumpy and bumpy, but there shouldn't be any specific nodules or masses that you feel. If you see that the skin is reddened or it looks pulled in, we call that retracted, or you're having an abnormal discharge from the nipples, those things would be concerning. You shouldn't wait to see a physician or a clinician whenever you feel something that's concerning. Schedule an appointment as soon as possible and discuss it with them. They'll also examine your breasts and determine what sort of imaging studies you need, if any.
So what are some steps that women can take to actually help reduce the chances of getting breast cancer?
So one's going to be knowing what your risk is, and at a physician's office you can discuss that. It takes into account your age and certain risk factors, family factors, whether you've had abnormal mammograms or biopsies in the past. There's actually an online tool that we use. It's called the Gale Model, and you can determine your risk. Once you know what your risk is, then you can better determine what screening tools are necessary.
So you talked about an online tool. How can we access that tool? You said the Gale Model?
Yes, it's actually on the National Cancer Institute's website. Let me see.
Can they just Google it? Just Google National Cancer Institute.
Yes, and
okay.
It's on there.
Great.
And it's you can go through it on your own to get an idea, but it is best to go through it with a clinician because you may not know what the words mean, mm-hmm. and you may not know the right answers to the questions. So together you guys could go through it. There are different things, depending on what your risk factors are, that you might be able to change. such as obesity is a risk factor, mm-hmm. and that's because that increases your estrogen exposure. So you might be able to work with your clinician on decreasing your risk by using diet and exercise. Mm-hmm. In addition, having a child early can decrease your risk, or breastfeeding can decrease your risk. So just determining what the risk factors are and whether you're able to change them or not. Some are not changeable, like sure. your age or your family history.
So coming of age, of course, many of our viewers are going to be some of our aging populations. Is there anything in particular that seniors or older adults may need to watch out for as far as their nutrition goes, or any warning signs in particular for that demographic?
Sure. It's always important to have a healthy diet. That way your immune system is able to take care of you if you become ill. And if you are diagnosed with breast cancer, it's going to make you stronger in order to tolerate a surgery if you need it, or the chemotherapy or radiation, depending on what's going on. So just a balanced diet is going to be very important. There are some studies, they're called observational studies, that have shown that a low vitamin D in women who had low vitamin D maybe were at more risk for breast cancer. And for women who were had a high diet in soy, they were at a decreased risk of breast cancer. It could be due to something else other than those two dietary factors, mm-hmm. but the observation has been there. Mm-hmm. My strongest recommendation would just be to maintain a balanced diet.
So are there any foods that we should just stay away from altogether?
No, not really.
No. It's just a balanced diet.
Exactly.
Gotcha. So in closing, what if our viewers want more information or resources? What number can they call? What resources are available to them?
Sure. There are lots of online websites, the National Cancer Institute, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. They have a lot of information. Baptist has a website. It's ebaptisthealthcare.org. And then you can always go to your clinician's office. If you don't have a clinician that you feel comfortable talking about this with, our office would be more than happy to come and see you and discuss the education that you're seeking for, how to learn how to do your own breast exam, or to determine what your risks are and answer any other questions that you may have.
Wonderful. So is there anything else that you would recommend, or any words of advice that you would have for anyone, for a woman, just in particular for the warning signs or things that they need to be aware of as far as breast health goes?
I think, you know, we do recommend self-breast awareness, knowing what your breasts look like and how they feel. And if you do notice something concerning, don't just, you know, put yourself to the side and not worry about it. It's important to bring it to the attention of your physician so that you can get properly taken care of. And then early on, even if you don't think that your risk is high, to discuss what some of the risk factors are. You may not understand what they are. And there are now medications even, or surgeries that we may recommend a woman to have so that she is able to decrease her risk.
Well, we appreciate you so much coming on the show today. Thank you so much for sharing with us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.